A very good evening to all our respected guests and to dear learners. I'm Dr. Ria Tukral from Homeopathic Academy, and I welcome you all again for yet another enriching discussion on a very important remedy, phosphorus, and its clinical approach with Dr. Ronak Shah. We have Dr. Ronak Shah live with us right now. But as you know, before we go ahead with this webinar, I have to make a quick introduction to the Homeopathic Academy for those people who don't know about us. So just give me a moment. Here it goes. So the Homeopathic Academy, or THA as we call it, is BJN's effort towards digitalizing homeopathy and providing a platform for quality education online. THA offers you a range of online courses by renowned intellectuals on numerous subjects of homeopathy at undergraduate, postgraduate, UPSC and CME levels. All these courses are enriched with state-of-the-art audio-video technology, text and vector animations, giving you an HD quality audio and video experience made by a dynamic team of qualified doctors, video editors and many more professionals. These courses will perfectly complement your studies to make learning an extraordinary experience. So as you see, you can see some of our courses currently streaming on our website www.thehomeopathicacademy.com. You can also see the course on Clinical Materia Medica by Dr. Ronak Shah, where Dr. Ronak Shah will teach us the distinctive features of some important polycrests of Homeopathic Materia Medica, describing them clinically and supported by case illustrations. A new course launched by our website is 4 Ways to Rejuvenate Your Practice with Dr. Frederick Royens, as you can see on your screens. Then we have 2 upcoming courses. One is Comparative Homeopathic Psychology by Dr. Philip Bailey, and the other UPSC course on General Anatomy and Physiology with Clinical Approach. So you can visit our website and go through these courses and enroll in them. We also have a 30% off happening on the website. You can avail it. This is a glimpse of Dr. Ronak Shah's course if you people are interested. So that's it about us. Thanks so much for listening. Coming back to this webinar, Dr. Ronak Shah, can we please have you here with us? Thank you, sir, for being here with us. Let me quickly introduce you to our dear learners today. So Dr. Ronak Shah, he is a dedicated researcher, clinician, teacher, and promoter of homeopathy. He practices in Vadodara and Singapore since 1989. He's a professor and head of the Department of Repertory at the Baroda Homeopathic Medical College since last 25 years. He's experienced in treatment of most difficult diseases, in treating chronic, recurring, and resistant diseases as well. He is an international physician and teacher. Over years, he has conducted many seminars and workshops for the practitioners, students, and public in many countries like US, Dubai, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, and India. He has written 4 books on homeopathy and published articles in various international journals and newspapers. He is the managing director of NGO, and he's doing philanthropic activities under it. He has served thousands of prescriptions by offering free medical care through charitable homeopathic clinic. You can see a book by Dr. Ronak Shah on your screen right now, Virithram and Egoistic Lily. He has organized various camps, helped during calamities, various research activities he has been carrying out. And he has a huge practice supported by clinical research-based data, statistics, and scientific documentation, making it unique in the homeopathic world. You can also see 2 more books by Dr. Ronak Shah on your screens. So we are delighted to have you here with us, sir. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Ria. Can you hear me properly?
Yes, I can hear you. And before I hand over to you, let me quickly explain our learners how this interface works. So on the right-hand side panel of your screens, you have a short chat box. You may type your question or whatever message you have for Dr. Shah right there and press the button next to it to send it to us. I request you all to send your questions only after Dr. Ronak Shah's lecture is over, as that might disturb. So without wasting any more time, I'm giving over to sir. Let's start learning. Sir, the platform is all yours.
Thank you.
So shall I start your presentation?
Yes.
Okay.
Good evening, everybody. I'm very much pleased and very much thankful for the Homeopathy Academy for inviting me as a speaker and to share my experience over here. I'm a part of the Homeopathy Academy since many years, and we have conducted many courses. And today, in our clinical Materia Medica course, I would like to share my experience with one of the most important remedy, phosphorus. As we know, this is the remedy is very important. We use in our practice very frequently in all potency. So to understand the central theme of phosphorus remedy, we have to start with the phosphorus itself. The mental symptoms are very commonly we have seen P sound for pleasurable, honest, open, spread, wild, sensitive, panic, hopeful, outgoing, restless, unfeigned, means very genuine, sympathetic, sincere, selflessness. These are the common thing we all know. Even the second, third year students of homeopathy also can speak about all these things about the phosphorus. Now today we want to learn more than that. Clinically, what we have observed in our practice, I'm practicing since last 30 years, so many phosphorus constitution we have seen, and then we have prescribed the remedy. Even though the certain pathology is not covered by phosphorus, also treated and they give the result because the constitutionally they are phosphorus, right? So I am sure today, if you learn carefully today and understand the whole lecture or webinar, you will never forget phosphorus in your life. Take it from me today, and that way we will learn step by step. I'm not going to teach Materia Medica. I'm going to teach what I have observed and I have seen in my practice. So here, according to the George Vitulkas, the essence of phosphorus is diffusion. The boundaries of phosphorus are so vague that anything can go in or out virtually without restrictions. If you take the jar of water and you keep a pink drop of ink, how they diffuse, you can see that how gradually everything is there. So this is the thing we have observed in a phosphorus patient. When they come to you, they communicate very easily, they can share their feeling very easily. So the essence running phosphorus is a lack of personal boundaries. This lack of boundaries that accounts for both the positive and the negative characteristic of phosphorus cycle. The lack of personal boundaries reflects on the physical, emotional, or mental. On the physical level, we see that almost any injury or stress result in hemorrhage. You must be knowing that the sheets of the blood vessels are weak and easily allow the blood to diffuse into surrounding tissues. And that is why we have a rubric, hemorrhagic tendency. The phosphorus is a leading remedy, right? Here I would like to share, now recently we are in a pandemic situation. So many patients are suffering from the COVID positive. I had one guy who was already admitted in an ICU, who had a high grade fever, 102, 103 fever, and the continuous coughing was there. He was had a chill also there, and then very much thirsty. Definitely, the first prescription was taken by himself is arsenic alb, because the arsenic is such a popular remedy nowadays. So he himself has taken, and then his relative has called me that he has started very much high grade fever. His D-dimer has increased, the ferritin level has increased, everything is, the reports are not good. But then also he is coughing continuously, high grade fever with the chest, is a left sided involvement, and then he has started hemoptysis. So these all things indicated me to give the phosphorus. And you know that if you read a Kent Materia Medica, after the arsenic, the phosphorus is also work very well. And you won't believe, after the phosphorus, he was improving hemoptysis, as well as he has started the bleeding from the nose also. So that is very much improved with the phosphorus, no doubt. The allopathy medicines was also continued in ICU. I won't say that only homeopathy medicine, but the bleeding part was very well taken care, hemorrhagic part very well taken care by phosphorus. And he was much better with that. So phosphorus patient is highly susceptible. The phosphorus patients are easily started from the sudden noise, a slamming of door or a burst of thunder. They can easily susceptible, very sensitive. Here we have a rubric for that, starting from noise, phosphorus, kalika, there are many other three mark medicines are there. They are very much sensitive, right? So during the thunderstorm, what happened? The normal person with hear a clap of thunder and then easily prepare himself for more. If you had a once thunder experience, then you will be prepared for the second thunder noise. But in a phosphorus, this is different. Patient, however, very sensitive, so will be started with each noise. They cannot control, and that is why they can startle in each noise. On the emotional plane, the phosphorus patient's emotions freely go out towards others. Very important. They quickly take on others people's thoughts and feeling. Oh my God, what happened to you? Are you suffering like anything? Oh, you may have a lot of problem. My sympathy is with you. See, such expression they cannot control. They will take out their sympathy on the emotional plane, and that is a phosphorus. Then for that, the rubric, we have sensitive to external impression, the phosphorus is only leading remedy, three mark is given. The cross reference is impressionable. That also we will discuss. Mentally now, so we have talked about the physical, emotional, now mentally, the patient easily forget himself, space out. He cannot think with his usual clearness of mind. The result is that the state of senility or imbecility, and that we will learn at the end of stage. Now we will learn the phosphorus in a stage wise. See, every remedy has a stage, and that we have to learn. So first stage, we all know there are extroverted, there are selflessness. Throughout the life, these people are very warm, very friendly, extroverted, who enjoy friendships and company very much, but also may enjoy solitude to pursue artistic endeavors. They usually talk a lot. They usually talk a lot and very openly. They communicate freely about their thoughts, about their feeling, whatever inside them. But they do not hold like monologues like Lachesis and not loquacious as a Lachesis. And that is why, if you see in a rubric, we have communicative phosphorus 3 mark, while Lachesis only 2 mark. Here the meaning is communicative. Then comes very important is sympathetic. We all are taught the phosphorus are very sympathetic. Such person is enjoyable to have around because he or she truly sympathetic. Freely putting the interest of friends above personal concern. They feel a lot about others. You can see from the picture also, the lady is really cares for old lady. These people are highly intelligent and refined. There are no secrets for such person. Whatever is on his mind, he shares freely. Warmth and affection diffuse freely towards friends and even strangers. So here the diffusion meaning is that they diffuse the feeling very easily toward the friends, even strangers. So here he or she life revolves around the interpersonal relationship. The communication channel in a phosphorus are so strong and open that he does not know which are his own thoughts and feelings and which are those of other person. The essence is the exchange of thoughts and feelings. They are very impressionable and trusting. They have many friends and they consider someone to be a friend even when they have only just met them. The classic picture of phosphorus, for instance, is the patient whom you feel you know so well after the first consultation that you would like him to be your friend. Brother and sister who are working in a corporate hospital comes in this category. You are admitted the first day and they are taking care as if they know you very well. So they come in that category. It is easy to feel relaxed in their company. Communication flows naturally with them. Such a person makes an enjoyable patient for the homeopath because he is impressionable and trusting. The phosphorus patient believes in what the prescriber tells him and follows the direction willingly and with the gratitude. The most important is gratitude. The right from the first interview, the patient views the prescriber as a friend. Shaking hand warmly, sitting forward on the seat, and perhaps reaching out to touch the prescriber hand or wrist when emphasizing a point. The patient gives symptoms freely without holding back. That is the most important thing. Here I would like to tell, just recently one Bengali lady who came first time to my clinic who has allergic rhinitis. Somebody has given a reference. Just came and she wanted to sit in front of me only because nowadays we are not allowing because we have to keep the social distance. But as soon as she entered, she sat over there. And then we told her, please keep a distance. And then after she started the whole story, hardly I have asked two or three questions. And our relationship with her in-laws, relationship with the parents, relations with the brothers, sisters, children, everything without asking them. So this is the beauty of phosphorus. They flow like anything and they feel that you are a friend of patient. So there is a predisposition towards the anxiety. This is a very important. Why they does like this also? There is a predisposition towards the anxiety of various types, but these are relieved easily by just few reassuring words. If you reassure them, they feel relaxed. This is the most important at this stage, first stage. And then we have a rubrics for that. That always we have to conform with a repertory, so our confidence for prescription will be too good. We have a rubric for a sympathetic affectionates. Is a rubric is there. We have a desire to be magnetized, as you know very well, the phosphorus constitutions. Sympathetic carcinosin phosphorus are the leading remedy, right? Now, how we differentiate from carcinosin? The carcinosin patients are the ones who sacrifice their comfort for others. Listen properly. They sacrifice comfort for others, who feel they owe everything to others, while others do not owe them anything. They are often very capable and intelligent people who do so. However, stand up for their own rights, even if it is that they are right. They are the people who seek to justify others. They justify others, but do not react if others are unjust to them. This is the difference. This is the carcinosin. They sacrifice their comfort like anything for others. If you know the person in a Gujarat, Sant Jalaram Bapa, exactly comes in this situation, carcinosin. This is the carcinosin state. Now, causticum and nitric acid are also sympathetic remedy, but there is a kind of selfishness behind the sympathy of these two. They stand to gain their sympathy where the phosphorus is genuinely sympathetic. Causticum is a sympathetic in the sense that he is anxious for others. He is anxious for others, but phosphorus feels anxiety of others. In causticum, suppose, take the example, very difficult to differentiate for the especially beginners. Causticum, if the child goes out in a party to enjoy and gets little late, the mother feels worried. Definitely, mother feels worried. Phosphorus is not so. Phosphorus feels anxiety for others when the other person is anxious. वो बच्चे की anxiety करती है, वो खुद की anxiety करती है. Phosphorus में क्या है? जब anxiety of others is there. If you have anxiety, they are also anxious. This is the difference between sympathetic and phosphorus and causticum. While nitric acid, sympathetic conditionally. You know very well nitric acid. As long as you are his friend, they do out of the way for you. And you will be confused. What kya kar raha hai banda mere liye? Itni help kar raha hai. But you are closest friend, best friend, that's why. But if by chance you have heard him, you have ditched him, then he will never forgive and forget. He will take revenge. So this is not a genuine sympathy in nitric acid. So these are the difference, carcinosin, causticum and nitric acid at the level of sympathy. Now here I would like to share a case of mine, a gentleman who was a very lively person, came 76 years old, who used to come in a young age, Rangit means at the age of 65. Now, at the age of 76, he came with the horses of boys in the evening since last 3 months. Laryngoscopy was done, and that was a vocal cord palsy was a diagnosis. Bladder urination frequently because of prostate enlargement, and the prostate and megaly was there. 77 gram weight was there. He loves chocolate, coffee, sour, ice cream, and sweet. Aversion to salty food, spicy food, thermally hot. The mental state, very emotional mind, likes to stay alone, independent, easily and adjustable, and very particular about time and punctuality. Perfectionist. If cheated by someone, then he can not take revenge, but cannot. Very cautious to put trust on others. Very active, enthusiastic. At the age of 76, he was doing so many social services. He is very cooperative, very confident, many social activities does, and try to help the needy people. Always take responsibility and try to fulfill. Craving for consolations, anxiety about the family, love perfumes and clothes. Totality we have collected, selected, and the rubrics are taken with repertorization. Ardent means very enthusiastic and conscientious about trifles, you know, very well. Independent at age of 76 years, responsible, very much sympathetic, urination frequent, prostate enlargement, vocal cord palsy, hoarseness of voice, chocolate desire, coffee, ice cream desire, salt aversion, sour desire, and sweet desire. Phosphorus 203 doses was given along with Sebal Sarulata, one of the most important medicine for prostate enlargement. Many times I give for 15 days, and gradually the doses was repeated. Here there is no full follow-up because of lack of time. And then he completely cured, which ENT has told that it's not possible. You wait and watch whether you will improve or not. We are not sure. So this was the case in spite of heart patient. All the totality, he's coming in, came in a stage one where the sympathetic is there, impressionable, enthusiastic. These all totality is selected, and the phosphorus were deep. Now stage two. So we have discussed stage one. Now stage two, anxiety and fears. Strong anxiety about health in phosphorus, everybody knows. They are easily frightened of any disease. It is as if they take over the complaint as soon as they read or hear about them. They get afraid that they might have the same disease. You all know that. The patient generally comes nowadays and, oh, I have a cough, cold, a fever. Please, doctor, I'm suffering from corona because my neighbor suffered from corona. So can you able to help me, or are you thinking like that? I'm suffering corona. And you will tell, oh, you don't have that much coughing, you don't have a higher fever, you doesn't seem to have weakness, and you are completely, or this is viral only or seasonal. So reassurance help him, the anxiety calm down. But next day again he heard about somebody's died because of other disease, again he will correlate that I am suffering from this, or he may develop the anxiety about that particular disease. So here we have a rubric, anxiety about the health own. Phosphorus is a theme. Hypochondric anxiety is also phosphorus is there. Because of these things, they are all the time thinking, all the time become anxious, but for disease of or for health. But they are just easily reassure again, and their complaint disappear. Once they come out from the doctor chamber, they feel relaxed. Oh, the smile on their face, relieve. But as soon as they hear about another disease, this reassurance can disappear again as quickly as it came. जैसे ही चेंबर से बाहर निकलेंगे और दूसरा कोई पेशेंट बाहर बैठा होगा और उसको कोई तकलीफ होगी, सो दैट फ्यू सिम्टम्स इफ ही हैज ही स्टार्ट कोरिलेटिंग दैट एंड देन अगेन द रीअश्योरेंस डिसअपीयर. दिस इज द प्रोसेस इन अ सेकंड स्टेज. सो इट इज ड्यूरिंग द दिस स्टेज दैट इज द अपीयरेंस ऑफ मेनी फियर्स. दे डेवलप फियर बिकॉज ऑफ द एंजाइटी too much, and that converts into the fear of dark, fear of being alone, fear of twilight, fear of thunderstorms. And we are using this all rubrics very frequently in our practice, everybody. And the most important I am using is fear of impending disease, fear something will happen. I am not able to tell you, sir, but something is going. I have a fear that something is good. Fear of ghost, fear of thunderstorm. At this stage, the anxiety and fears are fairly mild. If the patient comes in at this stage, you are lucky enough. You can definitely cure them with a normal thirst and refreshed sleep. Here I would like to share you another case of a gentleman of 57 years old suffering from the warts on the neck and face. There was no itching many years. Then he has a stiffness of both the knee joint, aggravation from sitting, rising from sitting and while sitting. Life situation, he did BTech from IIT Kanpur. Super intelligent person. He joined L&T in Calcutta as a vice president. His job is a vice president. L&T is a big company. He's a vice president. Happy at his job. Very good relationship with the wife. Very mild, adjustable, great anxiety and fear something will happen. He loves company. Very good decision power. Likes consolation. Very helping to others. He used to come in our NGO where the special children are there. He has helped a lot personally as well as from the company point of view also. Very responsible, punctual, does not like loud noise and crowd places. Like sports, games, cricket, loving and caring person and loves children. He loves fish, fruits, milk and sweets. Here the totality is, we have taken company desire, conscientious trifle, fear something will happen, very intelligent, IIT, Kanpur as well as vice president, responsibly taking too seriously, sympathetic, yielding disposition, skin warts, the phosphorus generally we are not using in a warts, fish desire, milk desire and sweet desire. After repertorization, the phosphorus carcinos incipia was coming very close, but confirmed with Materia Medica, we have given a phosphorus and the patient is completely cured of warts as well. Now stage 3, so that patient came in a second stage. Now stage 3, the patient becomes overwhelmed by anxieties and fears, overwhelmed. Where before they were very mild and manageable by simple reassurance, they gradually occupy more and more the energy and attention of the patient. The undercurrent of anxiety and tension prevents relaxation even during sleep. They wake up at night and that tells her, I'm not feeling good, I'm not getting sleep, I'm under fresh and I have a lot of anxieties. This commonly we get in our patients. So sleep disturbed from anxiety, very common general rubric. Phosphorus is only 2 months earlier. But eventually, the continuous anxiety become a free floating anxiety with no identifiable cause, there is fear that something bad will happen in the mind, continuously fear that something is going to happen. Every possibility anticipated with fear. There is a fear impending disease, particularly a fear of cancer rather than heart disease. Chota tumor hoga to ye cancer to nahi ho jayega. And eventually the fear of any impending disease. And we have a rubric, very important rubric, fear of impending disease. Nowadays also the people have this rubric because of COVID situation. The Kalikab is also another remedy. The Kalikab is a very loyal, very down to earth people, a lot of anxiety and very family oriented person. Very difficult to understand the Kalikab mentality. Kant has written in his book, first line, if you read Kant, Kalikab, difficult to understand, most toughest remedy. Not easily share their emotions to you. While phosphorus, the flow goes like this. Finally, the phosphorus patient falls into the fear of death, a panic state over the idea that death is imminent. And the patient feels like he's dying, especially when he's alone. When he's alone, a lot of fears are there. Cannot stay alone. And what they does? This is the point when the patient develops the need for company, because the fear that death is imminent. Need company. And that is, they will not allow anybody to go out, in old age people also, and the many other people who are at this stage. The need for company can be so strong as to drive him to leave his house. If nobody in the house, they will leave the house to find a friends to talk to. And this is not a need to talk to people about the health in particular, as we seen in an arsenical. They will think about only health. Indirectly, directly, they will ask about the health, what happened. And the health is shown, but here it is not. Rather, phosphorus just feel the need to talk to anybody about anything in order to relieve the panic. If they talk, the panic situation will be less. That is why they are communicative, they speak also, they need company and they want friends also. So talking desire to someone, phosphorus is there. Now the fourth stage. So patient can come into the first stage, second stage, third stage, any state come to you. As the states of fear increase, many of the other symptoms on the physical level disappear. If the patient comes in this stage, you will get no thirst, no craving for salt, no craving for fish, and you will tell, oh, this is not phosphorus. But no. If you have taken a history properly in a sequence, life situation, events, then you will understand. And that is why the constitutional treatment is the best. You will find remedy. Indifference is the fourth stage. The mind breaks down completely. The fear diminishes, but the mind degenerates. There is a difficulty in a concentration and inability to think correctly, or an inability to understand what is being said by others. Here you will be confused. Oh, he is not able to concentrate. He is not giving answers properly. He is not understanding. So you will think about Baraitaka, you will think about Haliboros, you will think about all other remedy. No, this is a stage four of phosphorus, who was a very live, gentleman, sympathetic, impressionable, extroverted person. Because of the situation in the life, he went in this stage. So the body and mind become weak. The patient becomes indifferent to company and indifferent to surroundings. we find a patient losing all ambition to do anything, there is a great indifference at a later stage. The company might also become too much for them. That is when they develop an aversion to company and conversation. See, previously they wanted company, but now they're losing all ambition to do. They become great indifference. They does not like company, and that is why the phosphorus are both the rubrics cover. They might become completely indifferent even to their family. Here you will be confused with Sitya, because we are taught by our material medical teachers from the second, third year, fourth year, that indifference always we look in the sepia. So phosphorus is also 3 mark, and many times like we used to ask question, how come phosphorus is indifference to the family? But this is the chronology, and that is why indifference to family. He cannot think with the usual clearness, cannot apply himself to study or mental occupation. Ideas come slow or not at all, result in a state of senility or imbecility. So very important, senility baraita kab is also there. Another common end result is a stroke in which mental faculties are lost. You must be knowing hemorrhage taken place in old age, cerebrovascular accident. So dementia senile and paralysis one side because of the apoplexy, phosphorus is there. The final stage can be very difficult one in which to prescribe, because there is a paucity of symptoms to distinguish phosphorus from the other remedies. Fourth stage, very difficult. For the reason, and that is why I always tell all beginners and students, careful history of past sequence of events. How he was as a child, how he was as an adult, how he has a relation with family members. So proper knowledge and events of the stages of pathology of remedies is necessary to benefit the patient. That's why we are asking so much in detail. Many times students ask me, sir, why are you asking so much? But this way we can find out a clear cut remedy. So again, I'm just revising what we have learned. Stage one is a extroverted, selflessness, sympathetic, intelligent, refined, impressionable, and trusting. This is the stage when the patient comes to you. Stage two also patient comes to you, anxiety and fears, but manageable. You give reassurance, they can manage for quite longer time. Third stage, free-floating anxieties and anticipation with fear, need for company because the fear that death is imminent. So patient can come into this stage. And the last fourth stage, difficulty in concentrations, inability to think, inability to understand, and indifference to company and indifferent to surroundings, and the end result in a senility or imbecility. So I am sure that if you understood properly this stage wise, so easy to understand phosphorus as a portrait or phosphorus as a constitutional remedy. Now, general characteristics we all know, but just revising: location generally lopsided, temperature cold, sensitive to thunderstorm. Physics we all know. Phosphorus give the impressions that you will be magnetized or the beautiful. The man will be handsome. The girl really will be beautiful, tall, slim, and very graceful, more flexible. The phosphorus physics is very similar to that of tuberculinum, a very closely related type. However, the phosphorus physics is more graceful than that of tuberculinum. The most important features we have seen, the eyes, which are unusually large, the border with the long eyelashes, giving a most attractive appearance of innocence. Most attractive. They love salt, they love fish, chocolates, they don't like salt and fish also. Thermally, they are warm-blooded or chilly. So in that patient, so the hot first patients, I had given a, even the hot I had given a. Formication at the tip of the fingers, loss of voice, burning is one of the leading remedy for try of burning you, very low, popular, and the hemorrhages of bright red blood. I am using this remedy in alopecia areata, asthma, bone disease, bronchitis, cancer, chronic cough and cold, diabetes, hepatitis, hemorrhage, liver disorders, pneumonia, paralysis, progressive muscular dystrophy, rheumatism, rhinitis, sleep disorders, tuberculosis, and loss of voice. Even you can use any diagnosis patients suffering from anything if the constitution and the mental state matches with phosphorus. So I hope you understood this remedy thoroughly, and you will get this knowledge, you will apply in your practice, and you can compare with other remedies also. Once again, thanks for listening me, and I'm very much thankful of THA, and I'm a part of THA course. Clinical Materia Medica is a course, Clinical Materia Medica course is there, and where you can go and purchase it. There is a maximum discount they are providing, and they are doing a very good services for our fraternity in homeopathy science. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you so much, sir. That was indeed very informative. We learned a lot about phosphorus today. I do hope that the learners would have loved the session of today. So let me quickly request our learners to please comment in the chat box with your questions now. We will begin the question and answer session in a minute. And while you are doing so, I would like to remind that our learners that THA has come up with an offer. So on the right hand side panel of your screen, you can see the offer. That's a 30% discount on all courses, including Clinical Materia Medica by Dr. Ronak Shah. And you can use the code FD30 to avail the discount on our website. So let's take up some questions, sir. We already have a lot of questions for you. Let me take up the first one. Sir, so a learner wants to know that, as you said, that both Kali Carb and phosphorus are attached to their families. Then how can we differentiate that?
Kali Carb is attached to his family. The phosphorus is not attached to any family. They are more sympathetic and more communicative with other people. They are not family-oriented people. They are more communicative and extroverted people. There is a vast difference. I just talk about the only the anxiety part. Okay. Anxiety is more in a Kali Carb. Phosphorus is also anxiety. That is the difference that I already explained.
Okay, sir. A learner wants to know, how can we differentiate between sepia and phosphorus?
Oh yeah, sepia is a totally big remedy. The hormonal imbalance taken place from the beginning, and a chilly remedy where they are not extroverted as like a phosphorus. We have seen they are not sympathetic like a phosphorus. They have their own evaluation, and that requires at least more than half an hour to understand the whole evaluation of sepia.
Right, sir. So a learner wants to know, can we differentiate the sympathy of causticum phosphorus and carcinosin?
But I have already told.
Yeah.
I just request to learners to go in a Clinical Materia Medica course where we have a differentiate all 10 modules, and it is a very good rate now the THA is offering you. So definitely you will learn this all remedies 10 modules. forever. You will never forget this remedy. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Because each remedy to evolve over here in the last 10-15 years will not possible. Here, 45 years more than that phosphorus required. So, very difficult
yes,
to
sir.
Differentiate.
Yes, so that's a huge remedy to
yeah.
understand. So, how will we DD with arsenic album for anxiety of health? I guess you have already,
already told
about
yeah,
this.
I already told so many things.
So you people can, you know, watch
yeah.
the webinar again. You will receive the replay link on your mails 24 hours later. So if you missed anything, you can watch it again and learn. Okay. Again, the same question, the sympathy, and you have taken it up. Okay. Okay, so a learner wants to know, how can we find phosphorus patients by miasm, by the way of miasms?
That's a good thing. Miasm point of view, phosphorus first is tubercular miasms, but then also it covers the all type of miasms. You know, psychotic also I have given a phosphorus in a warts, but the main is a tubercular, because it's quite close to tuberculum also, the constitution point of view.
Yes, sir. Okay. A learner wants you to differentiate between sulfur, phosphorus, and arsenicum. I guess you can enroll in Dr. Ronak Shah's course and understand all these remedies in detail and with audiovisual help. He has explained every polycrest beautifully in his course. Okay.
I'm very much thankful for those who have given a comment as well as who have purchased. Course, and they are still mailing me and then giving the comments that they have understood Madhya America very well clinically. So many abroad students, so many international students, doctors have purchased, and they are very happy with the clinical course.
Yes, sir, definitely. And a learner wants to know, is there any possibility that phosphorus may turn to natrum mute in the course of time?
Very difficult, because it's a totally different opposite for phosphorus and natrum muriaticum. They are very revengeful, malicious, they doesn't like consolations, and they have a lot of grief. Here the more anxiety and fear part is there, and they are very impressionable and the sympathetic. The natrum is not there. There are more deep-seated grief is there in a natrum.
Yes, sir. All right, so a learner wants to know, can you compare spongia and phosphorus in their sympathetic nature?
Yeah, that is, I was also learning, because sympathetic for spongia is a PMR, but spongia we generally use as a specific for the dry cough or only on the acute totality. Only one or two patients I have given a spongia, but I'm still not sure about the sympathetic attitude why the spongia have. So I have not experienced as a constitutional spongia remedy in my practice.
Okay, sir. I guess we have taken up mostly all the questions. Quickly send us your questions if you want Dr. Ronak Shah to answer them to you. And okay. So mainly the questions that are left are all the same. The same things. You can watch this webinar again or enroll in Dr. Anuksha's course.
You can tell to all the learners, all the learners are requested. You can see the all the many medicine on YouTube channel also, or the certain short medicines. Sir. No, Polycrest is, I am committed to THA only. So THA is a providing platform for the all homeopathy fraternity, and this is a wonderful work is done by Bijain Group of Industry, as well as Mr. Dale and Mr. Kuldeep Jain, Manish Jain, and then Abhishek and Ria. Very much thankful. This is the real way of learning internationally. Okay. Once again, I'm very much thankful for giving me chance to speak over here and share. Okay. Thank you.
We are more thankful to you, sir, for giving us your knowledge and spreading it, letting us spread it. And okay, a learner wants to know, can they have some books by you? Some publications or books by you.
Yes.
So where can they find that?
They can contact me directly on my number, or they can purchase from any publications directly from publications also, or they can purchase from me also. No problem.
Sir, also please tell your YouTube channel name to the learners, they want to know.
My YouTube channel is Dr. Rona Shah.
Okay.
Just click the Dr. Rona Shah.
Okay, so you have got your answers. You can subscribe to Dr. Ronak Shah's YouTube channel and enroll in his online course on our website.
I
and
for all beginners to join and enroll the course, because the beginning is now given the 30% discount. I think they're just really doing the charities only for the homeopathy. Because this code, how they made it, I know. I went over there and the audio, video, and then the infrastructure and technology they have used, fantastic, fantastic. Nobody can compare. Okay. So once again, I am requesting all the students, learners, and doctors, go and purchase this course. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Learner wants to know the YouTube channel name. Well, it's Dr. Ronak Shah on his name. You can find his YouTube channel. And you can also watch this webinar on our YouTube channel, the Homeopathic Academy, by the name of Homeopathic Academy. And you can find this webinar video also over there in a day or so. And even the earlier session that we did with Dr. Ronak Shah on Viratram album, if you want to watch that, you can also watch that over our YouTube channel, or you can visit our website and you can find the page Vialogs, and you can find all the webinar recordings and the links over there. So I guess we have taken up all the questions for today. Looking forward for a next Polycrest, the next session with you very soon.
Yeah. Okay.
If you'll allow us. And let's wind up here, if you'll allow me. Thank you for such an informative session, sir.
Please take the feedback of all the learners.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It would be helpful in the next.
Yes, sir. So please, you heard him. Please send us your feedbacks on our mail. You can send it tha@bjnrx.com. I am even typing in the chat for you all. You can send your feedback on today's webinar. We'll forward it to Dr. Ronak Shah, or you can even, you know, send him directly. No issue. Yes, sir. So Dr. Shah has sent his mobile number. You can send your feedback and your reviews to him directly. And thank you so much, sir. A very warm gratitude on behalf of THA and on behalf of BGEN. I apologize to those questions we couldn't take up. You can always watch the video again and even enroll in this course to get all your answers. And we will come up again with another webinar with Dr. Ronak Shah for all you learners. Also, I would like to let you know that we are running some quizzes and regular weekly quizzes on our courses, and can win an extra 10% or 30% off on some of our courses. So I'm sending that in the chat as well. You can take part in the quiz and win. So thank you, Dr. Shah. Would you like to say something before going?
No, thank you very much for organizing such a beautiful webinar, and it really improved our knowledge with our day, as well as the learners. They've given up so many comments in a past webinar also. Still the comments are going on that they really enjoyed Viratram Alp and they have purchased the module, so they were very, very happy. Internationally also so many colleagues have emailed me. So I'm really thankful for the technology they are using by the BGEN and Mr. Dell and all the team. Okay, thank you very much, and keep doing this work for the.
Thank you so much, sir. I would like to thank you all learners, the Homeopathic fraternity who joined us here today, and of course Team THA who has been working day in and day out to make this webinar as well as THA a success. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a great evening. Keep learning. Keep improving.